Hi, so in today's video, we are taking aging and growing younger to a whole new level, and I'm really excited to tell you about it. Hi. My name's Christine L. Conroy. Welcome to Happy Stuff and Fluff, a channel for women over 50 who are getting happy and growing younger. Oh my. Yeah, really excited to be talking about this. I'm not sure whether it's going to be split into two videos or it's going to be a long video that you might have to pause and come back to, but it is a special. A Happy Stuff and Fluff special. Okay, so if you've been with me a while, you may remember this video. I think it's about 2 years ago now. And I talked about the fact that at the time in the UK, the oldest woman, and I believed it to be the same in the US, I'm not so sure about the rest of the world at that time, but the oldest woman was 113. And then there was this Italian lady, if you remember her, she was celebrating 117. Now, what I didn't know then, well, and in fact, just let me tell you this also, that in 2019, as of July, the oldest person alive is 116, okay, which, obviously, amazing. But what I didn't know was that the oldest ever recorded woman ought to live is this lady, Jean Calment from Arles in France, and, oh, get this, who lived to be 122 164 days. Look at this picture. So these are extraordinary. Okay. Well, according to Harvard medical scientist David Sinclair and others, these living to these remarkable ages will not be extraordinary for much longer. Okay, now these scientists are not charlatans or dreamers or mavericks. These are renowned scientists from prestigious universities all over the world. I feel myself heart beating fast when I talk about it. So these renowned scientists from prestigious universities hold conferences apparently every 3 to 4 weeks around the world talking about longevity interventions. Okay, now, we're not talking if living to 120 is going to be possible. We're talking about when. We're talking about when. And the exciting thing is, it is not as far away as you might think. So, I mean, these scientists are turning everything we know about ageing on its head. Such exciting times in, I guess it's the science of ageing, in the field of the science of ageing. But the real exciting thing about it, and this is why I wanted to bring it to your attention, is that much of what they are discovering about how we're going to do this is accessible and possible for us to do for ourselves. Starting right now. So, do you want to live to be 120? Now, if you said yes to that, stick with me. If you said no to that, stick with me. So, Sinclair explains what he calls the information theory of ageing, and he says if we can work out what causes ageing, then we can figure out ways to treat it. Now, I say treat it because Sinclair believes that, well, he believes that ageing fulfills every category that medics define as disease. So he considers ageing in itself to be a disease. So he disagrees with the fact that we, you know, in general, we think that ageing is an inevitable and irreversible part of growing old or growing older. So he believes it's a disease which can be prevented, slowed down, and even reversed. Now, oh, this is a mind shift, obviously, in the way that we think about aging, but apparently in scientific fields that mind shift has been made, the mindset has been changed, and they are now thinking along the lines of aging being a disease. Now, clearly there's an awful lot of biological science involved in this, which I clearly don't have the time to go into and wouldn't understand it anyway. But I am reading, and if you want to know in more detail about the science behind all of this, this is Sinclair's book, which I'm getting through at the moment. Now, you can see it's quite a big book, and I'll talk more about that in a second. But he does go into lots of biological detail in that book about how they've got to, how they've arrived at the conclusions that they've come to. And I'll also leave some links to videos down below that explain the science simply but in more detail. So here are some facts. Look at this. There's no biological limit to human lifespan that's going to prevent us from living longer. I mean, that in itself. The pace of ageing, well, I guess we can get this one, can't we? It's easily influenced. It's malleable. So what we do in our lifetimes can greatly affect it. Look at this. Scientists now have a good understanding of why we age, and then also, in theory, how to reverse it. And work's being done all over the world on genes and molecules, which I'll be coming back to shortly, that can slow down and reverse aspects of ageing. Now, there are three main, what they call, longevity regulators that we have in our body. And there's a group of them called sirtuins. Now, there are seven sirtuins, and these are what we're interested in, the sirtuins. Now, these are genes that control the body's natural defences against diseases. And scientists believe that these are the genes that control ageing in the body. So when the body goes into defence mode, these genes kind of send out the troops and release all kinds, all the good stuff, in order to defend. Now, one of the experiments early days that was done on these genes was when they put more of these sirtuins into mice, and they discovered that these mice not only lived up to 20% longer, but they were healthier than other mice that were not given these sirtuins. So, long story short, and lots of good biological science, we now know that these sirtuins are what protects us against the diseases that we associate with ageing. So we're not just talking here about living longer, we're talking here about helping to protect us against, well, what are the diseases associated with ageing? Cancer, heart disease, diabetes, all of those things. I mean, it's just so exciting. What's going to be happening? And according to Sinclair, we're not talking the next, you know, decades. We're talking about in the next few years, in our lifetimes, ladies, in our lifetimes. So let me rephrase my question to you. Would you like to live to be 120, but be as fit and healthy as you are now? Did you say yes? I'm saying yes. So, what we need to do is to find ways of boosting these genetic pathways. Now, this is the exciting part, because exercise boosts these longevity genes. This is why people who obviously eat a healthy diet, that's a given, but people who exercise regularly can live up to 10 years longer. We know that already. Any kind of exercise that gets your heart rate going, so obviously aerobic exercise, but interestingly, especially for exercises of our age, interval training is recommended as being better for us older exercises, and this is It seems to engage more health-promoting genes and more of them in older exercises. So high intensity interval training, getting your heart rate up for 90 seconds, then resting and then doing it again and so on. Obviously, if you're going to start doing anything like that, get yourself a trainer. We also now know, and this is interesting too, that intermittent fasting also massively boosts these longevity genes. Now, we've talked about intermittent fasting before. I'll leave a link here. I started to do it myself. I have changed my routine a little bit, and I'll tell you more about that further on down the line. So what's happening in both of these cases here, of course, is that the body goes into defense mode, and that's what activates these longevity or these genetic pathways. So those are two things that anybody can do. You know, you can start to do that straight away. Now, before I tell you the next thing or talk about the next thing, I need you to understand that I am not suggesting you do this. I'm telling you what I do, at least what I've started to do, and I'll let you know how I get on. But of course, you must do your own research. I'm sure you will do, and don't be influenced by me. I just want to, just let me tell you a little bit more, because I haven't done yet, about who this guy is, David Sinclair. I'll just read this. So he's a PhD. He's a professor of genetics at the Harvard Medical School. One of the leading innovators of his generation, he has been named by Time magazine as one of the 100 most influential people in the world and one of the top 50 most influential people in healthcare. He's a board member of the American Federation of Aging Research and has received more than 35 awards for his research and major scientific breakthroughs. So he's a hard hitter, and I've done a lot of research on his work and what he's talking about before I decided to do what I'm going to tell you. So this is because a few years ago, I don't know quite how long ago, but I know Sinclair himself has been doing this for quite a while, they discovered molecules that actually mimic these sirtuins in terms of boosting these longevity genes. Now, one of them, I mean, there are 19 of them. We're interested in two of them, in particular, one of them that you will have heard of, and that is resveratrol. I mentioned it the other day. When did I mention it? When I talked about having a glass of red wine, because this is where resveratrol came into the public eye. It was because they discovered that's the ingredient in red wine that supposedly makes red wine good for us. Except that, of course, never so simple, is it? In order for that to help you, you'd have to drink lots of red wine. And of course, the downside of that is you'd probably fry your liver, or certainly women would not be able to drink as much red wine as you would need in order to get the benefits from it. It's also available in it's the red grape skin, so obviously you could drink grape juice and not alcoholic red wine if you wanted to. It's also in peanut butter, I think. So there's that. Now, the other molecule that you won't have heard of is NMN. I can't tell you what the full, I haven't got it down here, and I've forgotten it, to be perfectly honest with you, what that stands for, but I'll just show you what they are. Let me just have a look at this. Now, these two things are available in supplement form. This is resveratrol, which I've started to take. In tablet form. I do believe you can get it in powder form, but this is tablet form. I find that easy to take. And this is the NMN. Now, as you see, you can see in here, in order to boost the effectiveness of resveratrol, you need the NMN. I've started to take both of these, and as I say, I will let you know how I get on. But what we mustn't do is use this as an excuse not to exercise and not to eat less, because if you say, which I've heard him say in a lot of the talks that he's done, if you ask him, you know, what's the advice you would give to someone, what can we do straight away to help increase our longevity, he says, eat less. We've talked about this before too. I'll put that somewhere. But yeah, obviously he has a scientific basis for saying this. It's about eating less. Incidentally, the other thing he also does is he has saunas. He talks about changing the temperature of your body, you know, not like me sitting in the apartment working all day in a steady temperature, but to keep changing that temperature. And that also apparently is good for your body. So nipping outside and getting cold occasionally also helps. Now, I'm going to do in the next video, I'm just going to talk about what I'm going to do and put into place in terms of my well-being after I've listened to all this and heard all of this. So, an awful lot there. What I would like you to do is obviously listen to this, have a look at some of the talks, and like I say, I'll put one down below in particular for you to listen to. Apologies if I choose the one he's being interviewed by, I think it's called Josh Rogan, and they swear quite a bit. I'm not sure which one I'm going to use yet, but apologies in advance if it's that one. Try and forget that. It's so interesting, and he interviews him. Ask the right questions to give us the right answers, if you like. So there's that. This is the book. I'll leave a link down there to this as well. Like I say, it is a big book. Oh, but it's so interesting and so life-affirming, I can't tell you. So I'm going to do that. And I'm just so excited, as you can tell, about anything that's going to, obviously, kick cancer out of the way. Anything that might help us to do that. And all of these other things, type 2 diabetes, heart disease, anything that's going to help us with that. And incidentally, he says, Sinclair, if you don't believe this, it's simply because you're ignorant of the science. Okay, I'm going to leave it there because I can go on all day. And I know you've got other things to do. But we are a channel about getting happy and growing younger. So I thought it was important for you to hear it and to kickstart your own research into helping you to do that. Please let me know what you think. I'm dying to know what you think. And I'll see you next time. And until then, remember that on the Happy Stuff with Love, we are getting happy. And we're going to talk about that as well in relation to growing, living longer and growing younger. We're getting happy and growing younger. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.